But first, Australians are being told to get out of Tokyo to avoid possible radiation poisoning.
The government says it still holds concern for 11 people missing in the disaster zone.
Safe, sound and in the arms of loved ones.
The situation has definitely gone from bad to worse. I'm not trusting what the government's saying about the situation with Fukushima at all.
I think for my family, relieved, for mum and my partner, but I've got a job to do back there.
I just came back for my daughter and my parents.
For those still stranded in Japan, the government is offering loans to help pay for flights and is urging people to leave.
Australians should not travel to Tokyo and northern Honshu due to disruptions in infrastructure, strong aftershocks, and the continuing uncertainty about the status of the Fukushima nuclear plant.
But despite Qantas' promises of a fair deal, some, like Socceroo Mark Millian, claim the airline is profiting from the disaster.
How much did it end up costing you, if you don't mind me asking?
It was up around $8,000. For two of us, yeah. It was quite upsetting as well to see that, you know, the plane was only three quarters full.
But because people are desperate to get out, they're having to try to book onto flights, but if you haven't got the money to get out, you can't get out.
Tokyo's main airport is a hive of activity. Unlike the Australian government, Britain is chartering flights to Hong Kong and has set up information desks at airports.
We advise British nationals to follow all relevant advice from the Japanese authorities and, as an additional precautionary measure, not to go within 80 kilometres of the site and to stay indoors if they are within and not able to leave that area.
America is using passenger jets to evacuate thousands.
We're nuclear fallout refugees.
On the streets of Tokyo, there are no signs of panic. Still, queues for petrol are mounting and supermarket shelves continue to empty. Gabrielle Boyle, 10 News.